Assalamualaikum. Halo, selamat datang di YouTube channel Dr. P. Yohanita SPTHT. Di sini saya akan terangkan tes pendengaran dengan audiometri. Telinga berfungsi untuk pendengaran. Tes pendengaran adalah prosedur pemeriksaan untuk mengetahui kemampuan pendengaran seseorang dengan mengukur getaran suara dari luar yang menghasilkan gelombang suara yang dapat diukur dalam satuan frekuensi dan amplitudo suara terbanyak dihantarkan ke otak. Proses mendengar ini akan terganggu jika ada bagian telinga yang rusak, sehingga terjadi gangguan pendengaran. Maka, dilakukan tes telinga untuk mengevaluasi keadaan liang telinga dan gendang telinga dengan menggunakan otoskop atau remotoskop. Dan tes pendengaran proses ini dapat diperiksa dengan audiometri. Sebelum saya lanjutkan tes pendengaran dengan audiometri ini, jangan lupa like, komen, subscribe, dan tekan loncengnya. Tes pendengaran dengan audiometri. Tujuan dari tes pendengaran adalah untuk menentukan apakah Anda mengalami gangguan pendengaran dan juga seberapa ringan atau parahnya gangguan pendengaran tersebut. Tes pendengaran ini dapat menentukan jenis gangguan pendengaran yang Anda alami, yaitu gangguan pendengaran konduktif, gangguan pendengaran sensori neural, gangguan pendengaran campuran, persiapan untuk tindakan medis atau operasi, pemasangan alat bantu dengar. Riwayat gangguan pendengaran, bawaan lahir, paparan kebisingan, tuli mendadak, faktor penuaan, penyakit kronis, virus, akibat makan obat ototoksik, trauma kepala, dan alergi. Pemeriksaan telinga oleh dokter spesialis THT dengan otoskop atau remotoskop. Mengevaluasi telinga, membersihkan kotoran telinga di liang telinga, mengevaluasi gendang telinga. Kemudian dilakukan pemeriksaan timpanometri dan audiometri untuk mengetahui gangguan pendengaran. Timpanometri, pemeriksaan telinga tengah dengan timpanometri untuk mengukur dan memverifikasi adanya pergerakan gendang telinga, rantai osikel, refleks akustik. Tes ini digunakan bersamaan dengan audiometri nada murni. Audiometri. Audiometri nada murni untuk mendeteksi suara dilakukan di ruang kedap suara. Jenis dan volume suara yang berbeda akan diberikan melalui headphone dan vibrator. Jika ada suara, maka Anda akan memberi isyarat saat mendengarnya. Cara membaca audiogram. Melihat grafik audiogram dengan cara melihat dua sumbu. Sumbu horizontal, sumbu X. Frekuensi terendah 250 Hz. Tertinggi 8000 Hz. Sumbu vertikal, sumbu Y. Intensitas suara dalam desibel dengan level terendah minus 10 desibel atau 0 desibel. Ambang batas gangguan pendengaran. Di bawah ini uraian dari ambang batas gangguan pendengaran yang berbeda karena ditentukan dalam kaitannya dengan individu ambang pendengaran normal. Gangguan pendengaran ringan 25 desibel hingga 40 desibel lebih tinggi dari biasanya. Gangguan pendengaran sedang 40 desibel hingga 55 desibel lebih tinggi dari biasanya. Gangguan pendengaran sedang hingga berat 55 desibel hingga 70 desibel lebih tinggi dari biasanya. Gangguan pendengaran yang parah 70 desibel hingga 90 desibel lebih tinggi dari biasanya atau lebih dari 90 desibel.
You may be wondering, what is an audiogram? An audiogram is a graph that shows information about a person's hearing abilities. Let's take a look at the various parts of the audiogram. First, let's look at it from top to bottom. The audiogram measures sound intensity, or loudness, in decibels, which are listed from 0 decibels at the top to 120 decibels at the bottom. Running from left to right is frequency, or pitch, which is measured in hertz. The frequency starts on the left side with 125 hertz and goes up to 8,000 hertz on the right side. This is just like a piano keyboard that has the lowest frequencies on the left and the highest frequencies on the right. On a typical audiogram, you will also see two lines, one red and one blue. The red line represents the hearing in your right ear, and the blue line represents your left ear. If your audiogram does not have colors, then the line with the X's represent your left ear, and the line with the circles represent your right ear. Let's take a moment to focus on the sound loudness, which runs from top to bottom and is measured in decibels. If your hearing is normal, you should see an X or a circle that falls into the 0 to 20 decibel range for each frequency. That means you can understand speech in a noisy environment and no amplification is needed. If you have mild hearing loss, you will see the X or circle in the 20 to 40 decibel range. Mild hearing loss means you may be having difficulty understanding speech in noisy environments. It may also mean that you require a higher volume level when watching the television or listening to the stereo. Because of this, family members are often the first to notice. Moderate hearing loss will be marked in the 40 to 70 decibel range. With moderate hearing loss, you will frequently have difficulty understanding speech in noisy environments, including the telephone, television, and at public gatherings. You may find that you are regularly asking people to repeat themselves and you get frustrated because you are missing what they are saying. People may also tell you that you speak too loudly in conversations. If you have severe hearing loss, the X or circle will fall in the 70 to 90 decibel range. This means you are having significant difficulty hearing during most types of communication, and you may start avoiding noisy places where you know you will miss much of the conversation. And if your hearing loss is profound, you will see the mark in the 90 to 120 decibel range. At this level, you are having major communication problems in all situations. Profound hearing loss typically requires visual assistance while communicating, such as lip reading or sign language. Now let's look at the frequency, which runs from left to right. Vowels, such as A, E, I, O, and U, are the lowest pitch and fall towards the left side of the hearing range. Consonants, such as S, T, F, and SH, are higher pitched and fall towards the right side of the hearing range. Oftentimes, these higher frequencies are also associated with women's voices. This section of the audiogram is commonly referred to as the speech zone because most human voices reside within this range of frequency and volume. Now that we know what the various parts of the audiogram are, let's take a look at a few examples. In our first example, you will notice that this person has hearing that falls into the normal range up to about 1500 hertz. At 2000 hertz, their hearing starts to make its way into the mild hearing loss category, more so for the left ear. At 4,000 hertz, there's a significant difference and the hearing is now in the moderate hearing loss category. At 8,000 hertz, this person's hearing falls into the severe hearing loss category. In this next example, the person's hearing falls regularly within the mild hearing loss category, except at 4,000 hertz, where it drops slightly into the moderate hearing loss area. Congratulations! You now know how to read an audiogram. In our next video, we will quickly show you how to compare your audiogram to the fitting range for each hearing aid so that you can make an informed decision about the hearing aid that is right for you.
Hasil dari audiometri nada murni dapat dilihat dalam rekaman audiogram. Jenis gangguan pendengaran. Gangguan pendengaran konduktif. Gangguan pendengaran sensori neural. Gangguan pendengaran campuran. gangguan pendengaran pada struktur telinga, gangguan pendengaran konduktif, hambatan atau kerusakan struktur telinga luar dan tengah yang membuat Anda kesulitan untuk mendengar suara yang lembut atau pelan, gangguan pendengaran sensori neural, kerusakan permanen pada telinga bagian dalam, saraf pendengaran, dan otak, gangguan pendengaran campuran, kerusakan yang disebabkan oleh gangguan pendengaran konduktif, dan gangguan pendengaran sensori neural.
The human auditory system is composed of three parts: the outer ear, the middle ear, and the inner ear. Let's see how it works. The sound waves are picked up by the ear pavilion of the outer ear. They are then amplified and transmitted to the middle ear through the external ear canal. This movement of the sound makes this small membrane called the eardrum vibrate. These vibrations are transmitted to the ossicles located in the middle ear. The ossicles are the smallest bones in the human body. They are composed of the malleus, which transmits the vibrations, to the incus, then to the stapes, which acts as a piston that compresses the fluid of the inner ear. The cochlea is the main organ of auditory perception. It contains between 15 to 20,000 hair cells that detect vibrations of the liquid and generates nerve impulses that are sent to the brain via the auditory nerve. But this system is fragile and can suffer failures. We call this hearing loss, two of which are conduction hearing loss and sensory neural hearing loss. Conduction hearing loss can be caused by an obstruction in the ear canal, such as earwax, a perforated eardrum, a malfunction of the ossicles, otitis, or fluid in the middle ear. This type of loss can often be resolved by medical intervention and represents only 10% of cases of hearing loss. The second type of loss, sensory neural hearing loss, represents 90% of cases. It results from the destruction of hair cells in the cochlea. It is often due to aging, can be genetic, or the consequence of repeated exposure to very loud sound. Ugh. Okay, this type of loss is irreversible.
What?
Yes, it's a shame, but can often be compensated by hearing aids.
Penyebab gangguan pendengaran. Gangguan pendengaran konduktif karena cairan, alergi, benda asing, ruptur membran timpani, dan sumbatan pada liang telinga. Gangguan pendengaran sensori neural karena umur tua, obat ototoksik, suara keras, ledakan, dan tumor. Gangguan pendengaran campuran karena kelainan genetik, infeksi, dan trauma kepala. Terima kasih. Semoga bermanfaat. Jangan lupa like, comment, dan subscribe-nya.